Welcome to another training session. In today's tutorial, we will see what are the possible causes of the three-phase motor to trip and overcurrent. And we will see how to troubleshoot and solve this motor overloading problem. As we all might have faced this problem, when a motor trips, it's sometimes really hard to figure out what is the actual reason behind the tripping of the motor protector breaker. Let's quickly start today's tutorial. As you can see that we have a conveyor setup today. A motor and a gearbox is attached to the conveyor chain to drive it. As we turn on the conveyor motor by turning on the selector switch, the motor contactor turns on and the conveyor belt starts to run. After some time, the conveyor motor starts to overload and draws more than the rated current, and eventually the motor protector breaker inside the control panel trips and conveyor stops. If we go back and open the electric panel for this motor, you can see that the motor protector is tripped and thus cuts the power being supplied to the motor by turning off its contactor. Now the motor is tripped. First, we can check the motor nameplate and check the rated amps of the motor. We have to confirm that the tripping limit in the motor protector breaker is set as per the motor nameplate. In our case, you can see that the motor rated current is 1.6 amps. So we can set the current limit by rotating this knob using the screwdriver. After setting the current limit properly as per the motor nameplate, we can look for any loose connections in the motor circuit. You can inspect the wires connected to the motor contactor. Loose wire connections in the contactor can cause imbalanced currents across the three-phase coils of the motor. This causes motor protector to trip. If there is no loose connection in the motor circuit, we can move forward and check for any physical damage to the motor cable can cause short circuit in the cable. After checking the motor cable, next we can go to the motor and check the wire connections in the junction box. If the wires are connected properly to the terminals and there is no loose connections there, the next step is to determine if the breaker is tripping because of the mechanical or electrical component failure. We can check the temperature of the motor body and the gearbox. It will give us some idea what's the wrong going on with the system. For this, we will open the back cover of the motor. If you try to rotate the motor shaft by grabbing the motor fan, and you find really difficult to move the motor shaft, or it is not moving at all, this means that there is something wrong with the mechanical components of the system. So first of all, we will observe the whole conveyor system. Sometimes something stuck inside the conveyor belt or broken bearings in the system can cause the motor to get overloaded and cause the tripping of the breaker. Once we inspect the belt system, we will check the gearbox and open its oil plug and check the oil level in the gearbox. Lack of lubrication oil in the gearbox will cause the high friction among the gears inside the gearbox. Eventually, it can worn out the gears. Damaged gearbox is one of the reasons for the motor overloading. In this case, we have to replace the gearbox. Now there is another scenario. If we try to rotate the shaft of the motor by grabbing the fan by hand, and if the motor shaft starts to rotate easily and the conveyor belt is also moving, this indicates that there is something wrong in the electrical circuit of the motor. To investigate further, we will go back to the electrical panel and reset the motor protector breaker. We will try to run the motor once again, and as soon as the motor runs, we will try to measure the current on each phase of the motor by using an AC clamp meter. As you can see that the load current on the red face is 3.65 amps, which is almost double than the motor rated amps. Now if we check the yellow face, there is no load current at all. Blue face have 3.65 amps load. So now we have investigated that one motor winding coil is not drawing the current at all, and remaining two coils are drawing very high currents. We can now conclude that the motor protector breaker is tripping because of imbalanced current in the motor winding coils. This thing can only happen because of two reasons. Number one, the motor winding coil is open circuit. Number two, one of the contact is not working. To check further, we will go to the motor connection box and open it. We will remove all the connection and test the winding coils of the motor. We can test the motor winding coils resistance using multimeter, or you can use a magnetometer to test the motor windings. Want to learn how to use a magnetometer and test the motor winding? Video link is in the description box. First, we will set the multimeter in the continuity mode. Here we will try to check the continuity between the ends of the all three winding coils, U, V and W. As you can see that the winding coils are not shorted with each other. Also, the ends of the U, V, W coils are showing continuity. This means that the all winding coils are fine and there is nothing wrong with the motor. Now we have checked that the motor side is okay. There is nothing wrong with the motor winding. So we will connect all the wiring back to the motor terminals. Next, we will go back and check the contactor. Maybe the one of its contact is not passing the current to the motor winding coil and causing the current imbalance across the motor windings. We will remove all wiring and replace the contactor. After that, we will put back all the wiring and try to run the motor by turning on the selector switch. As you can see that this time the motor is not tripping or overloading and it is running smoothly. The problem was the faulty contact of the contactor for this motor. Now if we go back to the electrical panel and measure the current across the each phase, you can see that the current across each phase is 1.67 amps and it is very close to the rated current mentioned on the motor nameplate. The problem was the faulty contact of the contactor, which is not allowing the current to pass through the yellow phase. Now we have replaced the contactor and problem have been solved. So this is the procedure how we can investigate and solve the motor tripping problem. I hope you liked today's tutorial. Please do share, like and subscribe this channel, and till next video, take care and goodbye.